Hello and welcome to another video posted on Chris Wall, cookingwithchriswall.com. My name is Chris and I'm going to share with you a recipe today for a simple pound cake that comes out perfectly every time. Let's go to the ingredients. Right here, first we need some flour. We need 3 cups of flour, and I'm going to list all the ingredients in the bottom in the description below. 3 cups of flour, 2 cups of sugar, baking powder, 3 teaspoons of baking powder. You need 1 tablespoon of essence, either almond or vanilla, or whatever fragrance or taste you go for. I have 1 teaspoon of nutmeg and lemon and a lemon zest. Lemon and 1 tablespoon of lemon zest. And I also have some candied orange zest, which I'll also add in here for a little twist and a flavor. You'll need 2 sticks of margarine and 2 sticks of butter. Not all butter. 2 sticks of margarine and 2 sticks of butter. And 10 eggs at room temperature. Everything should be at room temperature. And I'll go ahead now and we'll start the process of mixing. We'll move over to the mixer. Okay, thank you. Okay, we'll first add our flour. First add our 3 cups of flour into the mixer. And we'll add our 2 sticks of margarine and 1 stick and 2 sticks of butter. And this we'll mix thoroughly. Once we get it in there, we start at a very slow speed on the mixer because you don't want to have a situation of flour in the air. So we start very slowly with the mixer, and then you increase the speed. So that's 2 sticks of margarine, 2 sticks of butter. In with 3 cups of flour. Okay. Oh. So, put the mixer on low. Well, if you're baking, you must have flour spilling around, but at least we don't have too much happening. So you let this go for at least until it gets smooth, and that takes maybe about 10 minutes. When it starts to come together like this, you can increase the speed a little more, and so that it will incorporate better and get a smooth mixture. So we let that go for at least 7 to 10 minutes until it gets until it comes together. And then I'll be back. Yes, guys, we'll be back. Now it's at a very nice consistency, and don't forget to scrape your sides now so that you get everything incorporated and mixed well. At this point, you'll start adding your 10 eggs, 1 egg at a time, and mixing it in well. Well, the 1 egg at a time thing is questionable. I mean, it's not that you're gonna overbeat the egg. Because if you're going to overbeat the egg, they're all going to be overbeaten. I mean, the first one is going to be crazily overbeaten. But It's just to incorporate it slowly so that it can mix it well into the flour. Instead of having a big, well, a clump of liquid in there, all the eggs just, you know, going around. But you mix them one at a time as you go ahead. Maybe as soon as you see it's all incorporated, you scrape your sides down and you add your egg. And just keep your mixer running. There we go. And I'll leave the method down on the description box for you so that you'll have a perfect idea of what I'm doing here. And here we go. And don't forget, guys, once you decide you're going to bake a cake or bake, put anything in the oven, preheat your oven at the 350 or whatever, or 375, whatever the recipe says. And you preheat your oven, and for cakes, you prepare your pans ahead of time, okay? Okay, so now I will put our last two eggs in and get them incorporated. Scrape down your side, the sides of your bowl, scrape them down. Make sure you got everything incorporated in there. And you're looking great with the consistency. After you've had your eggs all mixed in and incorporated, you're going to add your lemon zest and your vanilla and your nutmeg. So let's go in with the nutmeg. Get that incorporated. Get our lemon zest in there. Continue mixing. Get our almond extract in there. Get our candied orange zest in there. There's going to be some awesome flavors in this cake. You know you're going to love it. Try it, just let me know so that I have the, let me know in the description, in the comments, how you made out. So you let that work for a while. Let that keep going before we go to our next step. So whilst this is going here now, we got our fragrant stuff in there. The essence, the lemon zest, the orange zest. We're gonna add now our baking powder. 3 teaspoons of baking powder we're gonna go in with. Scrape down your sides to make sure it's incorporated. Get everything going and getting incorporated in there. Baking powder as well to incorporate it and mix in there. We're going to add the sugar. So that seems to be doing pretty well. So we're gonna add the sugar in here a little bit at a time so that you won't have a big mess. Two cups of sugar we're going in with. Now we're gonna let this go for a good 5 minutes or so, and so that the sugar can get incorporated and melted in there and everything can come together. So in 5 minutes we're gonna return. Yes guys, we're almost done. You're looking wonderful here in the batter. So here we are guys, it's finished. Let it go for that last 5 minutes or so, and you have beautiful consistency here, and all you need to do now is to pour it over into your pan and bake it. Okay, so we'll move over to our pans and get that done. So here we are, we have 1 7-inch pan and 1 8-inch pan. Them halfway up. Just put enough in there to go halfway up. Take a little more. This is good stuff, guys, so make sure you use all your batter. It's very rich. Get it all out. same over here. They have some ear bubbles in there. Well, just get it a few times like that. That settles everything and gets the ear bubbles out. Okay, and so my oven is set at 350, and we're just going to. You make sure your rack, you have it on the middle rack. That's my oven telling me that it's ready. Right here. 350. So, and in the oven itself, we raise the racks. I put it like in the, towards the middle, not too close to the end, to the bottom. Okay? So, here we go. We just situate our. Our cakes in there, and these bake at 350 degrees for about 45 minutes. Okay, so we'll be back when the finished product gets out of the oven, but we'll go in a little before that just to make sure that everything is going fine. And thank you for watching. Hi guys, I'm back. It has been approximately 45 minutes or so, and the cakes have taken a really nice color, and we're looking on them. You don't open the oven like halfway through before it's set. That's a no-no. It's kind of, it disturbs the process in there. So you just leave it until maybe like 5 or 10 minutes prior, then you can go in there and you can see and see what it looks like. And you know, you can look in on it at times, because there is the window, the glass there, and there's a light in the oven. So you can see how it's progressing. So right now we're gonna go in there, you'll see the color. That's taking a wonderful color. Lemon curd is set. I'm gonna go in with a toothpick and see how it is shaping up so far. Okay, as I can find the toothpick. There we go. A skewer is good too. All right. Start on the end. You go into the middle, comes out smooth. Once it comes out smooth, you know, you're good to go. Try both of them. It comes out really smooth. There's nothing on it. And they're already releasing from the edges. So that's another indication that your cake is done. If it starts releasing from the edges, that's an indication that your cake is set and it's done. Okay, so I'll get these out of the oven, put them on a cooling rack, and we'll see. We'll cut into them eventually. They'll be too hot to cut into them right now, but we'll cut into them eventually and we'll see what it looks like inside. Okay, I'll be back. And the pudding. Here we are, nothing on can. Oh, it's so spongy. It's so soft. Nottingham can. Let's try to get perfect slice up. Excellent. Look at that. Just look at that. How delicious. It's just wonderful. Awesome. Thank you for watching. Give this video a thumbs up, like, and make your comments. It helps me grow. And once again, thanks for tuning in, thanks for watching my video, and thanks for going to cookingwithchriswall.com. I'm Chris. Bye. See you later.